Hello, everyone, and welcome to another edition of the Lumu Flash Talk. What we see on the news is definitely the outcome of the worst case scenario. And yes, operating cybersecurity is hard, but it doesn't have to be hard. I actually founded Lumu based upon the belief that small and large organizations can operate cybersecurity better and more efficiently to avoid those worst case scenarios. And I have today a special guest with me, Chris Steffen. Chris is the Research Director of Enterprise Management Associates. And I invited Chris today to this Flash Talk to discuss how can cybersecurity be operated in a way that's better and that's more efficiently. Chris, thanks for joining me today.
Of course, great to talk with you again.
It's always a pleasure to have you on. Let's get started with the first question. And let's go straight to the point. Why does cybersecurity need to be operated?
Yeah, I guess I think it's obvious, but maybe other people don't. I mean, there are maybe a bazillion reasons out there why cybersecurity is relevant, from regulatory compliance reasons to, you know, just protecting your intellectual property to really just trying to take and protect your people and your assets. Whether you're a small, medium, large business, or even an individual consumer, I think it's incumbent upon all of us to really pay attention to, you know, basic cyber hygiene and basic cybersecurity best practices, you know, just in general as part of our overall computer technology culture.
Cool. Yeah, we see day in and day out companies with the mindset of deploying cybersecurity and that those tools will do the protection for today's attacks and tomorrow's attack, and then a week later they are on the news. So it's definitely way more than just deploying tools. And a question comes to my mind, and that's something that we also hear from customers. Can information security be bought? Is that something that you see as a reality?
I don't think it can be bought. I think it has to be one of those things where you can buy the tools to a degree, and I'm sure that we'll talk about it at some point. You can buy talent to try to help you with that. But I really think it starts with a culture. I really think that you have to want to have and engender a culture of security being important within your corporation and your daily lives. I think from there, you can take and buy the tools, you can buy, you know, support, you can work with, you know, third-party providers and MSPs, MSSPs, to try to alleviate a lot of the overall problems that come with security in general. But I think it really does start with the idea that you do have a desire to be more secure as an entity, as an organization, as an enterprise, and then what can you do from there? What tools can you buy? What so on and so forth. But that important part, that culture, I think really is where you have to start. And so then you can buy the tools, you can buy other things after then, but it starts with that mindset.
What about artificial intelligence? Is it true that artificial intelligence will fix all the problems in cybersecurity? What's your take on that?
No, I don't think it can. I think there always has to be a human component. We are humans, or at least I am still relatively. I like to think that, you know, using our judgment to determine the best way to proceed on some things is really important. I know that AI has the ability to lessen the load, as it were. And I think that that's really important too, right? I think that, you know, the days of having somebody, you know, sit at a computer and parse firewall logs and so on and so forth, I think those days are over. I think you can use AI to help you find alerts. I think that you can use AI to help identify things within your environment that might be going wrong. But when it's all said and done at the end of the day, I think that you still have to have a human involved to determine what needs to be done, what order things need to be done, and really to identify and evaluate the risk to the organization or to the individual of a particular event. It could be that it's nothing. It could be that it is a major drop everything, fix this now kind of thing. And no matter how good your AI is going to be, I don't know that I'm going to be comfortable, at least anytime soon, saying, yes, I'm going to give you the keys to the kingdom, AI, go solve our problems. I'm always going to want to have an input on what's going to happen within my environment.
So it definitely augments the capabilities of the security personnel, of the security operators. That's good to hear.
Yep. And
there's one thing, Chris, that I tell customers and prospects all the time, and is that when you ask a CFO of a company what's the EBITDA of the company, they tell you that number to the cent.
Sure.
However, when you ask the security operators or the CISO of a company, what's your state of compromise? They jumble, right?
They don't have any idea. Yeah, I know.
There's not a definitive answer on that. So we are a firm believer that measuring the state of compromise is something that helps to eliminate the noise about how to operate cybersecurity. Let's go to the next topic, which is what makes cybersecurity or operating cybersecurity so challenging, so harder, especially for small and medium businesses?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a lot of different things. I mean, there isn't a one-size-fits-all answer. It's this never-ending, you're never done task. I mean, there is not such a thing as being done with security. It's something that is a continuous process. I mean, you and I have talked about this many a times. It isn't something that it's a point in time, you're done, you apply your patch and you never have to think about it again. You are only done until you're doing the next thing, and then the next thing after that, and the next thing after that. And the technologies and the environment is changing so rapidly that there is never a done. That's one of the great things about technology, and one of the terrible things about technology is that it changes so fast and it is so reactive that you have to be constantly thinking about the fact that you are compromised. And if you're not thinking and you don't have that mindset, then you're not secure. It's really just that simple, because it is something that needs to constantly happen. When you talk about SMBs, they have all those problems even magnified. It is a very large business. You can kind of throw resources and money at it and hope to solve the problem. With an SMB, they don't have those kind of resources. They don't have those kind of the ability to just, you know, throw resources at a problem, money at a problem, and solve it. They really have to be very focused as to where their risks are. They have to be very clear as to what their responsibilities are compared to what their MSP's responsibilities are going to be. And they need to be cognizant of things like, you know, talent shortages and, you know, growing the business and how to deploy the best amount of resources where. And sometimes, quite bluntly, security is not always at the top of the list. I mean, we all just kind of survived the pandemic, and security sometimes was not always the top priority when the choice was security or keeping the business afloat. I understand that. I respect that. But at the same time, that's a constant problem for the small to medium-sized business that they have to be able to deal with.
Thank you for the advice and the insights on that. And you mentioned a topic that is relevant to this conversation, which are the MSPs. There's no doubt that the MSP play a key role in operating technology and cybersecurity for small businesses. How can the MSPs help to alleviate the burden of operating cybersecurity and secure the small and medium businesses in this journey?
Yeah, I think that the MSPs of the world play a critical role. I mean, we've talked about the talent shortages that are out there, and it really affects every sector of business, but it's particularly magnified with the small to medium sized businesses, because they don't have the resources to hire a squadron of CISSPs to, you know, secure their business. So they contract that work out to the MSPs of the world to act as their partner, trying to understand how to best approach the risks and the security controls that they need to implement within their business, because they can't do it by themselves. And I believe that in general, companies really can't do security by themselves anyway, but it's particularly magnified with the small and medium sized business. And that's one of the reasons they take and partner with an MSP. They look to those MSPs to help them understand the alerts. They help them try to understand and make sense of a lot of their compliance regulations. They have the ability to utilize the best tools and the best processes out there to hopefully take and translate that to the small and medium-sized businesses overall security. Whereas a small and medium-sized business doesn't have the ability to go buy their biggest instances of a SIEM solution or a risk management solution or an MDR or an XDR or the whole slew of tools that are out there. They're lucky a lot of times if they have some kind of antivirus running, right? And so the MSP is that trusted partner that helps them get through a lot of these security pitfalls, and it gives them a level of confidence and security that they would not be able to have otherwise.
And one of the things that we see also affecting the MSPs in their day-to-day is that most of the tools that they have been trying to deploy in cybersecurity have been built for large organizations, right? They have large budgets to deploy a large amount of resources to this problem. So picking and choose, I believe, the right tool that is designed for the challenges that the MSP have will go a long way. In that sense, Chris, we launched recently the MSP portal for MSPs that use Lumo that help them to manage under one single pane view of all the companies under management. Any comment on that?
I think it's obvious, right? I think that's critically important. I think that the vendors are a lot of times focused on the large enterprises out there. I think they see, you know, dollar signs when they're developing it. And I think that the small to medium sized businesses are sometimes left behind. Taking and creating tools that allow the MSP to use those enterprise class tools, but allow them to use those tools on a small to medium-sized business is perfect. It's really what an MSP is looking for when it's all said and done. They want enterprise class tools. It alleviates some of their burdens because they have the same, you know, talent shortages and you know, alert fatigue that everybody else does, but they want to use these enterprise class tools, but then they can cross apply the expertise that they have and the security brought to them by these tools to that small to medium-sized business. So I think the direction that Lumo is going in particular with MSPs and creating that kind of portal makes the perfect sense. They don't want 100 screens. They want one screen where they can take and manage all of their customers, all the MSPs customers in that one screen to be able to do a whole bunch of different things at once. Having multiple screens for multiple customers, I mean, you just end up with screen fatigue. And quite bluntly, again, you end up missing stuff. So no, I think that's absolutely the best direction to be going.
Fighting by what they call the portal fatigue. My friend, Chris Steffen, thank you very much for joining us.
Anytime. Always happy to do so, my friend.
It is always a pleasure to get your insights and share that with our audience. That was Chris Steffen from Enterprise Management Associates. Thank you, everyone, for your attention today. And until next time.